Good morning, everybody, and happy Friday. Hope everybody had a great week. I hope everybody was able to accomplish some great things this week. I know for myself, I was, and that always makes me feel good to know that I was able to achieve something great, you know. And when I say great, it could mean, it could be a small accomplishment or it could be a big accomplishment. No matter what it is, we have to, you know, pat ourselves on the back from time to time and say, okay, we did that. And, you know, just congratulate ourselves and celebrate that, because those small accomplishments lead to big accomplishments. I didn't get a whole lot of sleep last night. I tossed and I turned. I went to bed around 10:30 or so, and I was up until about 11:30. Then I was finally able to fall asleep. Then I was awakened to a night, you know, by a nightmare about 12:30-ish. And I stayed up for a few minutes trying to analyze my dream for a second. And then I fell back asleep, only to be awakened again at 2:45 by a phone call from my brother. And we talked for a few minutes. And then I've basically been up ever since then. And before I went, actually, you know, tried to go to bed last night, I prayed and I asked God. I said, okay, God, I'm going to do my morning inspiration in the morning. Please pour into my spirit the topic, you know, whatever it is that you would have me to speak about, you know, in the morning, you know, something that's going to help me and help others as well. And he did. And the funny thing about it is that when we pray and we ask God for things, we just don't know, you know, how we're going to meet up with the things that we pray and we ask him for. It could be, you know, like what I asked him to do for me last night. I prayed and I said, you know, pour into my spirit. But I didn't know I was going to have to be awake all night for him to do that. That's what I'm saying. It's like we pray for things in life, but we just don't know how we are going to come in contact, you know, or the journey that we're going to have to take to get to the things. But we just know that once we get there, or once we receive the things that we're praying for, that it's going to be great. So I'm going to share with you all what God poured into my spirit as I was tossing and turning all night. What I want to talk about is forgive, but don't relive. Meaning, when someone has offended you in any way, repeatedly, not just one offense. And, you know, sometimes we have relationship with people, friends, family members, significant others, and they offend us in some way, and we forgive them and we continue with them, only to be offended again, and sometimes reoffended habitually, you know, by these people. Sometimes, you know, when somebody does something to us, it's there comes a time when you have to just walk away from the situation and say, you know, I forgive you. I'm not angry with you, but I cannot place myself in a position to have that same thing happen to me again. And this is something that a lot of people don't realize, that it's okay to forgive, but don't relive. It's okay to forgive and move on. Forgiveness doesn't say, you know, it doesn't mean I forgive you, so now let's continue walking on this path. And, you know, that's not what forgiveness is all about. I mean, in some instances, you can forgive someone and continue on, and that person won't offend you anymore. But 9 times out of 10, if there's something about a person that you don't like, a way that they have that, you know, that's offensive to you, 9 times out of 10 is that person is not going to change who they are, because that's a part of their character. That's who they are. So if we can forgive them, but, you know, sometimes we forgive and we relive and we put a healthy boundary between ourselves and the people who have offended us, unless we want to be reoffended. So it's okay to forgive, but don't relive in a lot of situations. For example, you could be in a relationship with a guy and he does something to you so terrible and you break up with him. And then, a few months, weeks, or however long later, he comes back into your life wanting another chance. It's your choice whether or not you give him another chance, but don't forget about what he has already did to you previously when you were with him. You can give him another chance, but the probability that he's going to reoffend you is high. It's very high. So if something didn't work in this, if it didn't work in the situation, there was something that he did that caused the situation not to work. More than likely, if you can forgive him, but if you go back into that situation, you may experience that same thing all over again. Another thing that I want to talk about, what God, really poured into my spirit, and this was like revealed to me in a dream. I fell asleep for a few minutes within my tossing and turning, and I had a dream, and then I was awakened, and I was just up from that point on. And in the dream, I saw two people, and it was two ladies, and they were having a conversation. It was like I was not in the dream, but I was looking at a situation unfold. And the one lady was asking the other lady, "Well, why are you friends with her? She's done those, all this stuff to you. So why is it that you continue to be friends with this person?" And the answer that the other lady gave was that, "Well, we have so much in common. She likes to take vacations. I like to take vacations. She likes to have parties. I like to have parties." And I'm just looking at this dream like, what significance is this to me? And then the other lady, who was asking the question, said to her, "You have those things in common, but have you ever stopped to think about all the things that you don't have in common with this person?" A lot of people base their decision to be in relationships or to be friends with people based on the things that they have in common with the person. And unknowingly, you're going to, you have these five things in common, but the two things that you're overlooking that you don't have in common with this person, you're going to have to, if you join with this person, you're going to have to suffer the consequences from the uncommon factors, that this person have. For example, I'll give you a couple of examples. Two people are waiting on an elevator. They have in common that they're both waiting for an elevator door to open. One person is going up and one person is going down. They're going in two different directions. So that's an uncommon factor that the two people have. Another common factor that they have, along with both of them are waiting for an elevator, is that, they're both men. That's a common factor. Two men waiting for an elevator. One is going up, one is going down. Another thing they have in common is that, while they're waiting on the elevator doors to open, they discover that they both like the same football team. So they start talking about the upcoming football games and things of that nature. So that's a third thing that they have in common. So the elevator doors open. The elevator is pointing up. One is going up and one is going down. Okay, the person that's going up enters the elevator doors so that they can go up. The person who's going down has a decision to make. I have been sitting here chatting with this guy for the past 5 to 10 minutes, and we have all these things in common. I want to go with him. Do I want to go with him and continue the conversation and go in a direction that I'm not going in, and then take longer to get to my direct and, to my destination? Or do I fall back and just wait for the elevators to open and the arrows pointing down so that I can get to my destination? If we view the connections that we make in life by using that analogy, we would think twice before we get on the elevator with somebody or get into a relationship with somebody or go somewhere with somebody. You know, is that person going in your direction just because you have this in common and that in common and that in common? Are they going in the same direction that you're going in? What don't you have in common that you like? If the guy would have got on the elevator and went up, it would have taken him longer to get to where he was going. It could have caused him to be late to where he was going. It would have caused all kind of disruptions. If we really have to know who we're going with. I mean, and we really have to know who we're hanging with, basically. Just because you have something in common with somebody, that don't mean you're a perfect match for that person. You have to match with people on spiritual levels. I'm a artist, I'm a poet. I'm not going to hang around with actors. I mean, if I do hang around with actors, that's still in the creative field. Okay, so if I want to cultivate my talents in, you know, as far as in the arts, it wouldn't make a whole lot of sense for me to try to cultivate my talents and my gifts and the things that I want in life. It wouldn't make sense if I was to go and hang around with someone who basically don't want nothing out of life. You know, we have to, in order to cultivate who we are and grow into the people that God created us to be, we have to be around like-minded individuals, and we have to have more things in common than you know, just a few. We can have a few things in common with people, but if they have something that's uncommon with you that is will cause a negative effect on your life or where you're going or delay where you're going, you need to reconsider. You need to reconsider. Is it worth it? Is it really worth it because you have a friend that likes to party all the time and you like to party from time to time, but your friend that likes to party also snorts powder, cocaine. Okay, so you have a decision to make. If you're not a drug user and you have a friend that you have this one thing in common with that you both like to party, but she likes to do drugs. Okay, do you still go party with her? Do you think her abusing the drugs won't have a negative effect on you? That's something to think about. I mean, you might not think it will. And it may not. In some cases, you know, I'm not saying this scenario is going to play out the same for everybody, but chances are, if you're whatever you expose yourself to, it, I mean, whatever we expose ourselves to, it has some type of effect on us. Either it's going to have a negative effect on us, or it's going to have a positive effect on us. It's something else that I want to talk about. Excuse me, let me take a look at my notes for a second. Basically, to elaborate on the importance of making the right connections, this scenario or this illustration analogy, if you're standing next to, let's say, a dumpster, and everybody knows the smell that a dumpster has. If you're standing next to a dumpster and someone walks by and they smell the stench of the dumpster, their common senses would say to them, "Oh, that's the dumpster. That's not the woman that's standing by the dumpster that's reeking of that odor. That's the dumpster." Okay, that's common sense. Dumpsters give off a unpleasant odor. But what that person might say to themselves after they acknowledge the fact that it's the dumpster that's smelling, they may say, "Well, why is that lady standing by that dumpster?" I'm not saying that the people that we hang around, you know, reek of odor, or I'm not saying that they're trash because God makes no junk. But what I'm saying is a lot of choices that people make in their lives make them reap, cause them to be, to be basically toxic. It could, cause them to you to be in a toxic relationship with them. You're sniffing those odors, so some of that is going to rub off on you, whatever it is, whatever the people that you hang around with the most are doing is going to rub off on you. So make the right connections in life. If you want to go somewhere, you have dreams, you have goals, you have, desires to be successful in life, you have to get around some successful people in order to make those things happen for you. I'm going to bring this video to a close now. I hope everybody have a great weekend, and I will see you back on Monday. Blessings.